Hi everyone, myself Lohit Dalal. Today I am going to explain unit 6, transmission media. These are the contents I am going to explain. First, there is an introduction about transmission media, classification of transmission media, principle of light propagation through a fiber, conditions to achieve the total internal reflection, different types of fibers and their properties, general overview of optical fiber communication system, primary elements of optical fiber communication, benefits of optical fiber communication and applications, and conclusion. First, there is an introduction. In introduction, so you have to learn what is transmission media. Transmission media means it is a physical path between the transmitter and receiver for certain amount of data to be transmitted. Okay, so that is called transmission media. Okay, so again, transmission media is broadly classified into a different types. First, types of transmission media, there will be a two types, guided media and unguided media. Again, there is a in guided media, there will be a twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, optical fiber cable. In unguided media, there will be a radio waves, microwaves and infrared rays. Okay, so let us discuss one by one. So first one, the guided media. Okay, it is also referred as a wired or a bounded transmission media, means it is a physical path or a physical link exists between the transmitter and the receiver. So it is a physical length exists between the transmitter and the receiver is known as a guided media. There are some features. So there will be a connectivity will be there, physical connectivity will be there, so that the data to be transmitted with a high speed, and there is a security, okay, because the other person will not listen or will not get the data. Okay, so there is a more secure and used comparatively for shorter distance because of wires or cables. Cables can be built for a shorter distance only. So next, there are three major types of guided media. First one will be a twisted pair cable. So in twisted pair cable, it consists of two separately insulated conductor wires wound about each other. In generally, such pairs are bundled together in a protective sheet. They are most widely used in the transmission media. Twisted pair cable means two wires are twisted together. Okay, they are separated by an insulating material like plastic. Okay, so again, twisted pair cable is separated or classified into two types. Those are unshielded twisted pair cable in UTP and shielded twisted pair cable. Unshielded twisted pair cable, this type of cables has the ability to block interference and does not depend on the physical shield for this purpose. It is used in telephonic applications. Unshielded means the cable has ability to block the interference, means so this cable is having a ability to block the interference, in a twisted pair cable, the cable is twisted, copper wire is twisted, above there is some amount of plastic material will be deposited there. Okay, but cable is twisted. So there will be again advantages: the least expensive, easy to install, high speed capacity will be there, high speed data transmission will be there. And disadvantages: though susceptible for external interference, means there will be external interference or a disturbance. So lower capacity and performance in a comparison to the STP, means shielded twisted pair cables. Short distance transmission due to attenuation, means there is a huge amount of signal attenuation will be there in a unshielded twisted pair cables. So next, there is a shielded twisted pair cables. Shielded twisted pair cables, this type of cables consist of a extra jacket to block the interference, means whatever the extra interference coming from the atmospheric or some data noise or a disturbance. Okay, there is an extra jacket. It is made up of a optical fiber it is made up of a plastic or some insulating material. That is, separately extra jacket should be made, jacket should be fixed on the wire. So the example, there will be Ethernet and voice or data channels for a telephone lines. And advantages of this shielded twisted pair cables are better performance at a higher data rate compared to the UTP, means unshielded twisted pair cables, eliminates the crosstalk, means disturbance, comparatively faster. Disadvantages: comparatively difficult to install and manufacture, and it is a more expensive and it is a more heavier. So next type is coaxial cable. Coaxial cable, it is an outer plastic. It has an outer plastic covering and containing a two parallel conductors, each having a separate insulating protection cover. Okay, coaxial cable transmit the information in two modes, baseband mode and broadband mode. Okay, so coaxial cable means there is a wire is situated in the middle, and above there is a plastic or a metal shield will be insulated above the wire, copper wire. Okay, coaxial cable means the wire is fixed in the center of the cable, means angle, center angle or axis. Okay, so we are naming it as a coaxial cable. So next, there is advantages: high bandwidth, better noise immunity, easy to install and expand, inexpensive. Single cable failure disrupts the entire network, means that is a disadvantage of the coaxial cable. If connection cable cuts, so entire connectivity will be lost. So next, optical fiber cable, it uses the concept of reflection of light through the core made up of glass or a plastic. The core is surrounded by some less dense glass or a plastic covering is known as a cladding. So cladding means there is some insulating material will be deposited on the glass. We are naming it as a cladding. It is used for transmission of the large amount of data. Optical fiber cable, it is usually made up of a core and cladding. In a core, there will be a core is made up of a glass. Above there is a cladding is made up of a insulating material. So next, advantages of the optical fiber cable are: it is having an increased capacity and bandwidth, lightweight, less signal attenuation, means there is a signal attenuation, signal loss will be there. Immunity to electromagnetic interference, resistance to corrosive materials. And disadvantages of optical fiber cable are: difficult to install and maintain. Okay, difficult to install and maintain means if suppose cable cuts, so that time you can't connect directly. Okay, some equipments will be there, some slicers will be there, so it is difficult to connect once it back. Okay, so some instruments we needed, and also technicians are needed, so you can't connect directly. So high cost, it is a high cost. Unidirectional means you are going to send a signals in a only one directional. If you want to send another signal, okay, another information, you need to select another fiber and then you have to transmit the data so that you can do the bi-directional communication. So next, unguided media means it is known as a wireless or a unbounded transmission media. So there is no physical medium exist. Okay, so you are going to transmit the signal in a air or a media. So there are some features: signal is broadcasted in a air, whatever I said, no, in a media only you are going to broadcast. In a free space you are going to broadcast the signal. It is having a less security because somebody can access the data. Okay, so there is, again, you have to use the some coding techniques to secure the data, encryption decryption techniques while transmitting, encryption and decryption at the receiver side. Okay, so used for longer distances. So there are three types of unguided medias. There are, first one is the radio waves, second one microwaves, infrared rays. In radio waves, having a frequency range of 3 kilohertz to 1 gigahertz, and radio waves having a AM and FM radios, and cordless phones uses the radio waves for transmission. Further categorized into terrestrial and satellites. For long distance communication, radio waves are used. Microwaves having a frequency range of 1 GHz to 300 GHz. These are majorly used for mobile phone communication and television distribution. So next, infrared rays. Infrared rays having a frequency range of 300 GHz to 400 terahertz. It is used in TV remotes, wireless mouse, keyboards, printers, etc. And infrared rays will not penetrate the obstacles. Okay, so will not penetrate the obstacles. Usually we are going to use it in a TV remotes, wireless mouse, keyboards, etc. Within a building we can use. Okay, so it will not penetrate the obstacles or any objects. It will not pass. So next, optical fiber communication is a method of transmitting the information from one point to another point with the help of a light. Okay, so you are going to transmit the voice, audio or a video with the help of a light signal transmission. Okay, so optical fiber cable, it is made up of a dielectric dielectric waveguide, and that operates on the optical frequencies, means light wave frequencies. Okay, whatever the frequency of the light wave will be there, on that frequency only it is going to operate. So next, there is a functions of the optical fiber. It confirms the electromagnetic energy is in the form of light. It takes the electromagnetic energy in the form of light within the surface and guides, means it is going to transmit the light in the direction of parallel to the axis. Means optical fiber is made up of glass. Glass is placed in the middle, means center of the cable, that is axis of the cable. So your light is in a direction of parallel to the axis. Okay, so light is going to pass through the parallel to the axis. So there is a principle of light propagation through the fiber. When the light ray is incident on the interface between the two medium having different indices at an angle greater than the critical angle, the light gets totally internally reflected within the medium of higher refractive indexes. See here. So when the ray of light incidents on the some surfaces, okay, there will be two different refractive indices, n1 and n2. Okay, so here refractive index of n1 is greater than the n2. So what happens, the ray of light incidents, okay, so in angle of incidence is more than the critical angle, means more than the 90 degree, then ray of light is going totally, it is going to reflect back to the same medium which one is having a higher refractive index, on that media only it is going to refract back. Okay, so that n1 is greater than the n2. So next, there is a refractive index. Refractive index is defined as the ratio of velocity of light in the vacuum to the velocity of light in the medium, is known as a refractive index. So there is a propagation of light within the optical fiber is explained with the help of a ray theory. Okay, in a ray of light always travels more slowly in a optically dense than in one that it in a less dense medium. Okay, so usually optical signal or a light wave travels more slowly in a more dense medium, means more refractive index medium. Okay, so when the ray of light is incident at an angle of phi 1 normal at a surface of the interface between the two dielectric refractive indices, example there is a refractive index is n1 is a made up of a glass, it is a n2 is made up of a air, so reflection occurs. So that can be shown in the figure, you can observe that. So next, if the dielectric on the other side of the interface has the refractive index n2 which is less than the n1, then refraction is such that the ray path in this index medium is that angle phi 2 to the normal, where phi 2 is greater than the phi 1, means that time refraction is going to operate. Okay, so and also the angle of incidence phi 1 and the refraction phi 2 are related to each other. Refractive indexes of the dielectric is given by Snell's law. Snell's law of refraction, it is given by n1 sin phi 1 equal to n2 sin phi 2. When the angle of refraction is equal to 90 degree, the refracted ray is emerges parallel to the interface between the two dielectric materials. When the angle of incidence is more than the 90 degree, that time reflection is going to occur. Okay, so means angle of incidence is greater than the 90 degree means greater than the critical angle. Okay, suppose angle of incidence is less than 90 degree, that time the refracted rays emerges parallel to the both the dielectrics. It means it is will be a middle. So next, so this is last next. This is the limiting case of refraction and angle of incidence known as a critical angle. Means critical angle means when the angle of incidence is more than the 90 degree, that time ray is going to reflect back to the same medium. That is a critical case or a limiting case. Okay, on this condition only we are going to pass the signal in optical fiber communication. See here, last 7th point, at the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, the light is reflected back into the originating dielectric medium with high efficiency around 99.9%. This phenomenon is called as a total internal reflection. Means angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, means angle of incidence means incident ray having some angle that is greater than the 90 degree, that time whatever the ray is incident on the medium, that is going to reflect back with the efficiency of 99.9%, means some 0.009% signal will be lost, light wave is lost. Okay, means this phenomenon is known as a total internal reflection. Okay, so on this phenomenon we are going to pass the signal in the optical fiber cable. So next, conditions to achieve the total internal reflection. The phenomenon of total internal reflection occurs the interface between the two dielectrics of different refractive indices. Okay, two different refractive indices only when there will be a light is incident on the dielectric of lower refractive index. Light is incident on the dielectric of lower refractive index from the dielectric of the higher index. Okay, so that time ray is going to reflect back. Next, there is another condition. The angle of incidence exceeds the critical value, means angle of incidence should be more than the 90 degree. So that condition should be achieved. So there are different types of fibers. There are different types of fibers and there are different properties. So based on the fibers used in the communication, they are classified into step index fiber. Step index fiber again classified into single mode, multimode, and second one graded index fiber and multimode fiber. So let us discuss one by one. So first one, step index fiber. The step index fiber, the refractive index of the core is maximum and constant throughout the core. Means refractive index of the core is maximum and constant throughput. The throughput of the core. Okay, so there is a stepwise decrease in the index of the refractive or respective cladding. Okay, so there will be a optical fiber is made up of a core and cladding. Okay, so there is a refractive index is going to change stepwise in a step index mode fiber. The refractive index of the cladding is given by n2 equal to n1 into 1 minus delta. So n1 is the refractive index of the core, delta is the relative refractive index difference between core and cladding. Step index multimode fiber, the difference between refractive indices of the core and cladding is more. There is a more difference exists between the core and the cladding. Its core has a larger diameter. Core is having a larger diameter and cladding is having a minimum diameter. So it is used in short distance communication because it is having a more number of attenuations. Signal will be lost. Okay, maximum signal will be attenuated. So next, there is step index single mode fiber. The difference between the refractive indices of the core and cladding is very less. difference between the refractive index of the core and cladding is very less. Okay, so the core diameter is very small. Core here in a stub index single mode fiber, there is a core is very small and cladding is more. Here it has a low attenuation and very high bandwidth, so it has low numerical aperture, so that means angle of acceptance will be there. Okay, so these are used for long distance communication. So this can be used for long distance communication. Next, there is a graded index fiber. The graded index fiber, the refractive index of the core varies parabolically. The refractive index of the core will be there, right? That is varies parabolically such that the maximum at the core axis and minimum at the core and cladding boundary. There is a boundary exists between the core and cladding. Okay, so there is a it is going to vary with the parabolically, but it is having a maximum at the core and it is maximum at the core and minimum at the core cladding boundary. The refractive index of graded index fiber is given by equations. So where r is the radial distance from the fiber axis, alpha is the core radius, n2 is the refractive index of the cladding, n1 is the refractive index of the core. So delta is the refractive index difference. How you calculate n1 minus n2. Okay, so alpha is the refractive index profile is given by n1 square minus n2 square divided by 2 alpha square. For a parabolic type graded index fibers, if alpha equal to 2, so when alpha equal to infinity, n of r equal to n1. So this diagram, nature of light ray propagation and refractive index profile. So next, general overview of optical fiber communication system. Okay, similar to all other communication system, okay, the primary object of the optical fiber communication system is to transfer some information like voice, video, audio, okay, from source to destination. Okay, the general block diagram as shown in the figure, it consists of a source or information. Source is going to generate the some kind of information that is given to the electrical transmitter. You are going to convert that voice or a video audio signal into a electrical signal, then you are going to give to the optical source. Optical source means electrical signal is going to convert it into optical, means light. That light is given to the optical fiber cable. It receives the light signal, it is passed through the cable. After that, the photodetector will detect the light, then it is given to the electrical stage. It is going to convert that light signal into an electrical signal, then it is given to the destination. Okay, so next, there is a primary elements of optical fiber. Primary elements of optical fiber communication system. Okay, so primary elements of optical fiber communication system means there is a basic elements of the optical fiber communication system. Okay, usually the optical fiber communication system is consist of a transmitter, regenerator and receiver. Okay, so see here, so source, it is going to generate the some amount of information that you are going to convert it into electrical signal. Okay, after that electrical signal is given to the driver circuit, and then it is given to the light. Okay, light or optical source. So driver circuit used to control the intensity of the light. Okay, so driver circuit and this optical emitter or a light, this forms the transmitter. So after that, there is a connector, means in order to connect the fiber, you need connector. After that, if suppose fiber's length is smaller, then that time you need optical slicer or optical connector. You are going to make the length of the optical fiber larger, so that next in optical fiber will connect optical fiber. Next, if you want to connect it, two or more connections at the receiver side, two or more persons has to want to receive that signal, that time you are going to use the optical couplers. So after that optical coupler, so there is a light signal is coming. So in order to increase the strength of the signal, in order to recognize the original signal, whatever the data to be transmitted at the transmitter side, so you need regenerator. Regenerator is made up of a optical transmitter and electronic circuit, and optical receiver will be there. Optical receiver will does what? It is going to convert that light signal into electrical signal, then it is going to amplify the signal in a electronic circuit. Okay, so then it is given to the optical transmitter is again, it is going to convert the electrical signal into light signal, then it is given to the optical slicer or optical connector. So next it is given to the optical amplifier, so that it increases the strength of the light, okay, strength of the signal, so that it is given, so that in order to recognize the original signal, in order to recover the original message, whatever the data to be sent. So optical amplifier, it amplifies the signal, then it is given to the connector. Through connector there will be again photo detector will be there, or a photon detector. Photo detector means light detector circuit will be there. Again it is given to the amplifier increases the strength of the signal, then it is given to the destination, means the amplifier increases the strength of the signal. Photodetector, it is going to convert that light signal into a electrical signal. Okay, that electrical signal is amplified and it is given to the destination. Okay, that is the working of the optical fiber communication system. This is the principle of optical fiber communication system. So next, there are benefits of optical fiber communications. So it is having a very low transmission loss, and also smaller size and lightweight, and also it is having a high signal security, immunity to interference and crosstalk, and also there is a total electrical isolation in the transmission medium, and also immense bandwidth utilized, means you can utilize the perfect bandwidth. Okay, and also it works on the principle of light wave communication or a total internal reflection. Okay, these are the benefits of the optical fiber communication system. So next, there is applications. Okay, in applications of optical fiber communications, they are used in wide range of different fields, like public network field, which includes trunk networks, junction networks, local access networks, submerged networks, synchronous systems, and in the field of military applications, civil consumer, industrial applications, field of computers, which is used in the center of research now, right now. Okay, so next conclusion, there will be some negativities of the optical fiber communications, like suppose there is a optical fiber connection, okay, wire lost, optical fiber cuts. Okay, there will be some bulky or heavy expensive instruments are needed to connect. Okay, and also technicians, okay, who are knowledgeable persons are there, they only have to connect. Okay, and until and unless, as soon as computers are capable to processing the optical signals, okay, you need computerized equipments to recover that. Okay, so once it does, okay, this problem has to be overcome. So these are the references.